Let's continue on the passion according to GH. The divine for me is whatever is real. But kissing a leper is not even goodness. It is self-reality, self-life. Even if that also means the leper's salvation, but it is first of all one's own salvation. The saint's greatest benefit is to himself, which does not matter, since when he reaches his own great largeness, thousands of people are enlarged by his largeness and live from it. And he loves others as much as he loves his own terrible enlargement. He loves his enlargement with impiety for himself. Does a saint want to purify himself because he feels the need to love the neutral, to love whatever is not accretion, and to relinquish the good and the pretty? The great goodness of the saint is that to him everything is the same. The saint sears himself until he reaches the love of the neutral. He needs that for himself. I then understood that in whatever fashion, living is a goodness towards others. Living is enough, and that itself ends up in the great goodness. He who lives totally is living for others. He who lives his own largeness is making an offering, even if his life takes place within the incommunicability of a cell. Living is such a great offering that thousands of people benefit from every life lived. Does it pain you that the goodness of the God is neutrally continuous and continuously neutral? But what I once wanted as a miracle, what I called a miracle, is really a desire for discontinuity and interruption, the desire for an anomaly. I called a miracle exactly that moment in which the true continuous miracle of the process was interrupted. But the neutral goodness of the God is still more appealable than if it were not neutral. To have it all, you must do is go. To have it all, you must do is ask. To have it, all you must do is go. To have it, all you must do is ask. And the miracle can be requested and had since continued. The miracle can be requested and had since continuity has interstices that do not discontinue it. The miracle is the note between two notes of music. It is the number between number one and number two. To have it, all you have to do is need it. Faith is knowing you can go and eat the miracle. Hunger, that is what faith is in itself. And needing is my guarantee that to me it will always be given. Needing is my guide. No, I did not need to have had the courage to eat the paste of the roach, since I lacked the humility of the saints. I had given to the act of eating it a meaning of maximum. But life is divided into qualities and kinds, and the law is that the roach shall only be loved and eaten by another roach, and that a woman in the hour of love for a man, that woman is living her own kind. I understood that I had already done the equivalent of living the paste of the roach, for the law is that I must live with the matter of a person and not of a roach. I understood that by placing in my mouth the paste of the roach, I was not stripping myself as the saints do, but was once again yearning for the accretion. The accretion is easier to love, and now I am not taking your hand for myself, I am the one giving you my hand. Now I need your hand, not so that I won't be scared, but so that you won't. I know that believing in all this will be, at first, your great solitude, but the moment will come when you will give me your hand, no longer out of solitude, but as I am doing now, out of love. Like me, you will no longer fear adding yourself to the extreme energetic sweetness of the God. Solitude is having only the human destiny, and solitude is not needing. Not needing leaves a man very alone, all alone. Ah. Needing does not isolate the person. The thing needs the thing. All you have to do is see the chick walking around to see that its destiny will be what neediness makes of it. Its destiny is to join as drops of mercury join other drops of mercury, even if, like each drop of mercury, it has in itself an entirely complete and round existence. Ah, my love, do not be afraid of neediness. It is our greater destiny. Love is so much more fatal than I had thought. Love is as inherent as wanting itself, and we are guaranteed by a necessity that shall renew itself continuously. Love already is, it is always. All that is missing is the coup de grace, which is called passion. The coup de grace, which is called passion.